In the heart of bustling Shanghai, a cultural exchange unfolds as moviegoers gather to experience a slice of global cinema right here. On a business trip to the Shanghai International Film Festival, how could I miss out on watching a movie?
My pick for the day is a British film entitled The Great Escaper.
The cinema is packed with people even on a rainy weekday. Since 2024, the landscape of imported films in China has evolved dramatically. After experiencing a decline from 2020 to 2022, the market is now flourishing with a diverse array of foreign films making their way to Chinese screens.
开心啊，多些国家的嘛，就是大家都开眼界。我们可以通过引进更多的、更优秀的。
更全面的电影来满足这样的一个影迷的需求。我有了解到，这个现在这个政策就是说要加大对外国电影的进口。我们将秉持开放包容的胸怀，优化电影引进政策，鼓励支持引进业务。As this year marks the 30th anniversary of imported films entering China's market, the Chinese mainland has grown into the largest overseas box office for many imported films. Works such as The Boy and the Heron has outperformed in the Chinese mainland, even surpassing their domestic and North American revenues.
首先是因为中国的电影市场足够大，这个就是我们想先有一个大市场的这么一个红利，其实在大市场下，完了找到合适的影片、合适的内容，用合适的宣传发行的方法，我这个得到这个更优的结果，我觉得也顺理成章。
Guan told me that opening the door wider showcases China's confidence and the dual strategy of bringing in and going out.
更多的也是一种自信嘛，就是说明中国的电影本身质量和产业已经到发展到这个程度了，让更多的影片走进来，不但不会对中国电影本身有伤害，反而对中国的电影市场和中国电影的从业人员的水平和制作能力，我觉得都是有提高的帮助。
Seeing the rapidly changing landscape, Tran Anh Hung, a Vietnamese-born French filmmaker and jury member of the festival, remains encouraging and positive.
You just have to make good movies. When the film is beautiful, it travels all over the world.
And the audience also travels all over the world, through every frame and story brought by international filmmakers. We see not just a film, but a bridge, connecting us to the world and inviting the world to discover us.